First things first, I'd like to thank God for waking me up this morning and giving me this opportunity. I'd like to thank the church for having me here, and I'd like to thank my brothers from the New Beginnings for coming and showing support to me. I really didn't know what to share this morning, so I kind of prayed to God and asked that He just speak through me. And I guess what I want to really just say is that my story begins with coming out blue, out of the womb. I had the cord wrapped around my neck. I was born upstairs June 9th, 5 something in the afternoon, so it was a struggle from day one. And I grew up around a lot of drug addicts and drug abusers, poverty. I grew up really poor. I remember, going to school and looking in lost and found for shoes and jackets and things like that. So life was pretty rough for me. And I found myself surrounding myself with the people that I grew up around, which was the drug dealers, gangsters, and what have you. So 7 years old, I get the bright idea that, hey, I'm gonna join a gang. And I got jumped in or whatever. And I was representing the gang. And from there, my life just kept going downhill. I'm living at home with my mom. And my mom, she has all kinds of different guys in and out the house. We're getting beaten. Bad things are happening to us and to my sisters. And, I'm a 7-year-old and I'm trying to fight grown men off my family. But, I'm getting beat up and I'm not winning. So at an early age, I kind of lost my faith. I didn't feel like there was a God looking after me. And then teachers at school, I remember they'd tell me, if anything's going wrong at the house, come to us, and we'll help you. Well, I put my faith in teachers and I told them what's going on at home, and they ripped my family apart. So I really stopped trusting everybody and trusting religion and all that. I didn't think, what kind of a God would allow something like this to happen to me? But, I'm going to fast forward a little bit because, lo and behold, I was wrong about everything. God saved me for this moment in time to share my experience, strengths, and hopes, of the dark ages I came by. I've been shot. I've been stabbed in my back several times. I've been taken hostage. I've been almost beaten to death. Matter of fact, I used to be homeless. But, there was a specific time not too long ago before I made a change in my life and gave it all to God that it was going to be my last night here on earth because I was still in my very active gang member days and I had some problems with some other people and I was sure to lose this war that night. I had a gun, they had more guns, and it was only me and it's all of them. And I really didn't care about life anymore because I'd already lost my family due to my addictions. And I didn't never understand why I was addicted to anything. I didn't wake up one morning and decide, this is gonna be a career for me. Like, I just wanna wake up and be a career criminal. This is not what I chose. I have no idea why I was like this. But God's an awesome God. And I am a success story. So that night, I was homeless and I'm about to go have a shootout with these people. I called my wife and my kids, because I already lost them, but I just want to tell my kids I love them. I want to tell my wife I'm sorry. And something kept nagging me in the back of my neck. I was homeless, but I had a cell phone, so I was trying to find a Wi-Fi signal. So what happened is at this church called Crossroads. So I stood there and I texted my wife and kids, and I left. And on the way walking, something stopped me. There's another church. For some reason, it stopped me and paused me right there. And it's called Choose Life. Well, I also had my little pocket Bible on me that day that I kept on me. That's all I really had. And there at that church, I opened it up. And it was a message about the prodigal son. And it made me cry. And, it was just too much of a coincidence, Choose Life. And then opening up the Bible to see this message, it was like it was written for me. He said that he wasn't done with me yet. And at that time, I was done with myself. I always begged for death. I didn't like this life. I hated it. I hated everything about me. I hated everything I put everybody through. And I couldn't go on another day living like this. So at that time alone, I gave it all to God. And I told him, fine. I've tried everything I could possibly do to get myself killed, and it's not working out. So my life is yours. Do with it as you will, because my will and self will run riot. And from there, he's opened up doors for me. You know, I had to go back to jail for a little bit in order to stay sober because I didn't want to be homeless and stuff like that no more. I just couldn't do it no more. I sought out help, and I got that help with the New Beginnings. Since coming to the New Beginnings, about the first 3 weeks, I had an identification again. I was a human being again. I was actually part of society again. A month after that, I have my job. I'm a crew member at Little Caesars Pizza. A month after that, I'm a crew leader at Little Caesars Pizza. And a month after that, I'm now the assistant manager of a multi-million-dollar corporation, Little Caesars Pizza. This was something that I never thought was possible, which I knew it wasn't possible for me to do it alone. I take no credit for this. This is all given to God. You know, it's a justification that it's always God's time, you know what I mean? And I really don't know what else to say. It's just amazing to be here standing in front of you good people today. Somewhere I always wanted to be, you know. I always got visited by people in jail from churches who would come and give their testimony to us. And I remember thinking to myself, wow, they must have a good life, you know. The grass is greener on the other side, probably. I sure hope they have. But I was too selfish and self-centered to go about the way of getting it, you know. I still want to do things my way. And since giving to God, it's all His way. He tells me what to do, and I do it. I don't question it. I just do it. Whatever my conscience speaks to me that's right, that's what I do. I don't follow my whole mind and whole ways of thinking that says, you know, this is too much for me. This is too hard for me. Life is too much of a struggle. I can't go through with it. Let's just go use. I say, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. And everything's okay. I no longer have to worry about anything. I give all my worries and my stresses to God. You know, it's a saying in the Bible, and I'm not good with quoting scripture, but it's like, come to me, all who are leading and weary. Take my yoke upon you. My burden is light, my yoke is easy, something like that. And it's awesome. I mean, it really is. It's cool. like living for God is really, really good. I haven't had a stressful day. Now, don't get me wrong, being an adult, it isn't all sunshine and rainbows. You know what I mean? Since quitting drugs and alcohol and coming into this new life, I faced a lot of adversities in my life. I faced people judging me. I faced me judging myself. I faced my past, my baggage of my past, and, you know, but God lets me know that that's all gone in history now. I am a new creation. I am a new being. And I can do everything through the power of God, which is in me. And that's all I got this morning, guys.